As you recap your golfing life thus far, Tony, what would you say has been your greatest frustration?
My greatest frustration is the fact that I have to live out of a suitcase and in hotels and motels. I've hit too many bad shots, really, that meant something to really be able to pick out one, and I've been quite delighted with quite a few good ones.
Wait a minute, Tony. You said Palmer would never get over his collapse in the National Open. You said that earlier.
Oh, well by
now,
that...
Well, I was going to say, you find you can get over missed putts that cost you a lot of money?
Not really, because they all come back, whether it be when I'm laying in bed or traveling on an airplane or some conscious moment, a lot of these things come back. I don't have anything quite like the burden Arnie has, but he'll live with it.
What has been your most rewarding moment, apart from the putt right here at Westchester that won you the Thunderbird?
Well, the putt that I made from about 10 feet to win my first pro tournament. I think that in everybody's, in every pro's life, that very first tournament win was the one that really got the monkey off his back, and it certainly did me.
When you do give up golf, when you give up the pro tour at least, how would you like people to remember you? How would you like them to characterize you?
Well, I really haven't thought of that, Howard. I'd just like to play good golf, successful golf, as long as I can, and if I'm remembered, that's fine.
You want to be remembered as a great golfer?
Oh, I don't know. I'd rather be remembered as a decent sort of person and an athlete.
That's
as far
exactly
as great.
The point I was getting to. So that'll be enough for you to be thought of as one of the glamour boys in the golden age of golf.
And the right way glamour, yes.
Uh-huh. And the glamour includes champagne.
Would you like some?
I'd love some.
Why not?
You pour.
I'll pour it. We ought to have a little pop here, too, Howard.
I guess.
Hang on to your hat.
We got it. You pour.
There's nothing like ending a nice day or a good game of golf with a little taste of the bubbly.
Tony, I enjoyed it.
Cheers.
So you've met Tony Lema in his last and perhaps his only in-depth conversation. You know, it's a circumstance, a tragic circumstance, that just this past Monday, I received a letter from Tony Lema, dateline Akron, Ohio, where they held the PGA. The letter said this. It was dated July 22nd. Dear Howard and Emmy, thank you for a delightful stay the other day. It was very pleasant. I only wish I could have stayed longer. I feel we did pretty well on the film. I do hope it turns out the way I am, the way I think the public knows me. I hope we can work together again sometime. Sorry I'll be unable to go to London with you for the Clay London fight. I have to play Cleveland that week. Have a ball. Love to the family. Very sincerely, Tony Lema. How do you remember Tony Lema?
Just like that, Howard. That was Tony.
Champagne on the green. A Howard Cosell production in association with WABC-TV.